Okay, what is assault and battery? Well, these are words that are commonly used together but often misunderstood due to criminal shows, etc. Well, assault and battery is a crime, but assault and battery is also a tort for which you can recover. Okay, so assault is this. It is the putting of someone in apprehension of an immediate harmful touching. Okay, it is making someone believe reasonably that they are going to be subject to a harmful touching. It could be that I act like I am going to hit you with something or throw something at you. In that situation, I've assaulted you because you believe that you're going to be subject to that harmful touching, that being hit by whatever I throw or whatever I'm going to hit you with. You believe you're going to be harmed. Okay? A battery is the actual harmful touching, the illegitimate or illegal touching of another person. So to hit somebody with an instrument or with your fist is a battery. To touch someone in an inappropriate manner, okay, is a battery, okay, commonly called a sexual battery because you touch them in a sexual manner inappropriately without their consent. So that would be a sexual battery. So that's the separation from assault and battery. Assault is putting someone in the apprehension of an immediate or imminent harmful touching, and battery is the actual touching of that person. So one more aspect about assault: the threat has to be immediate and imminent. That is, I can't call you on the phone and say, next time I see you, I'm going to hit you. Okay, that is not assault because it's not immediate. I'm not putting you in immediate apprehension. Rather, it's too far in the future. That is an element that has to be ready for assault. Now, if I told you that in person and I began walking towards you, you would reasonably believe that I'm going to hit you, and that would be an assault. Okay?